Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved one, today is Monday, being the 13th March, Lenten week 5. Our readings will be coming from Daniel chapter 13, verse 41 to 62. That's the short verse of that reading. Our responsory psalm will come from Psalm 23. Our gospel message will come from John Gospel chapter 8. Verse 1 to 11. The theme of our message today is God of Justice. We had the story of Susanna. Judges wanted to have sexual relationship with her. She refused. They concocted a case against her, produced evidence against her, false evidence, and condemned her to death. And she cried to God, "You know, I have not done all this since. You are the God of justice. Allow me to die for committing no sin." And God of justice prompted a surety to a young man called Daniel. And Daniel cried out, "My hand is not in the death of this innocent lady." And the people said, "What is he talking about? Come in our midst." And he went into the midst of people. Say, how can you be part of condemning an innocent person without examining the case, without knowing the facts? And they sit down for the case to be reviewed. And Daniel began the first investigation in the world people never knew about. He brought the two judges who gave evidence against them, separated them, and ask the first one, "You say you saw this woman committing adultery with somebody?" Say, "Yes." "And you couldn't help to arrest the man?" "No. He's so strong. Under which tree?" And the man said, "Under a mastic tree." Okay. He called the second one, "You say you saw them?" "Yes." "With your two eyes?" "Yes." "Under what tree did you see them?" And the man said, "Under evergreen oak." And the people shouted, "Oh!" I started praising God who saved innocent ones who hope in him. And with this, the two men went the way they planned for the innocent lady. They were condemned to death according to the law of Moses. What they planned against her, that became their portion. That's the God of justice in action. And now we're in the gospel message today. Jesus, after praying at Mount Olive, came out to the temple to preach. And people gathered around him. I was about preaching to the people. The Pharisees and scribes brought a woman completely naked. And she would call this woman in adultery. And the word Moses empowers us to stone her to death. They wanted to tell Jesus, say, "What did you say?" And Jesus bent down and was writing on the ground. They continued pressing on him for an answer. Jesus looked up and said, "If you know you have not sinned, be the first person to cast stone on this woman." And he sat down again and started writing on the ground. And they started departing one by one, because all of us have sinned and fallen short of the grace of God. But sometimes you go about behaving and you say, "You are sinless." And they all left and left the woman alone with Jesus. And Jesus looked up and said, "Woman, have anyone not condemned you?" She said, "No one. And my sin do not condemn you. But go, don't sin again." Don't sin again. They didn't bring the man she was caught with, but brought only the woman. And was ready to stone her to death, but not the man. They could have brought both of them if they believed in true justice. And they are condemning what they are doing themselves. And you can see today, Jesus established just system, just world, just community. As we best, peace can only be here. People can be safe and free only in justice. When there is injustice, there is all amount of anarchy in the system. When there is injustice, terrorism will take its fuel, will take over the day. When there is injustice, you see people deny their fundamental rights. But when God of justice comes, people who are denied their rights will have it back. Though I should walk in the valley of shadow of death, no evil will I fear, for you are with me. So even if I walk in the shadow of death, I will not fear, because the Lord is with me, God of justice. And we ask God to give us the spirit of justice, to give us the spirit to get to Daniel, to stand up against injustice, give us the spirit to get to Christ today, to establish justice on earth. We ask through Christ our Lord. May the blessings of Almighty God be upon all of you as we live in justice and peace in the world. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all.